In the beginning, the sausages were one long chain. But then they were split apart. To what end? Who knows? By whom? Who knows? When? Where? Why? How? All questions we may perhaps visit again in the future. But for now, we ourselves have no choice but to move ever onwards. And that is not a good place to put that, I'm fairly sure. I think I would have been better off putting it on this side. Well, we have a goal in mind. We've seen a lot of puzzles way off to the north, but seems like we're going to take a brief side jaunt south and southeast first, before we kind of curl around and go our way up there. But I'm happy to at least be examining new puzzles now. I really did think for a little while that... interesting. I guess it's a kind of like a biome thing. Anyway, I thought I was gonna be stuck for a little while longer on those puzzles. I was prepared to have to budget a little bit more time for those, like two or three more episodes, but no, just coming back to them fresh will do wonders sometimes. What is the deal with airline food? Well, the conventional approach won't work, but we do have our very own ladder here. We can do this. That has to be relevant somehow. Additionally, the grills are shaped like that, and we want to bring that tree back. How does this start out? Like we start out like this. So, oh. So interestingly, this land already starts bridged. Okay. So, that does seem to be the only way we can support that with one sausage. And then we got, like, what I can only describe as the grand altar, or church. Maybe it's a theater, or just a pulpit, I guess. I guess we could say it that way. And we do have another choice of puzzle here. We could work on that one instead if we would prefer. Or, moving even further onwards, that bridge over there is incredibly suspicious. Moving further onwards, we have another plinth, so we've got two plinths ahead of us, and then we've got to, clear this out one way or the other. Presumably, the puzzles are set up in such a way that only once we solve both of them... Well, only once we solve both of them will we uncork this, or perhaps solving one, which is the first solution, which is actually supposed to be solved first, will uncork this, and the other one is that. But as I was saying earlier, we've seen situations where you had to solve two puzzles in order to uncork one green sausage. Remember the idyllic times back in Worlds 1, 2, and 3, where you had to solve, like, 10 puzzles in order to get one extra green sausage? Good times. Good times. Well, as usual, I suppose I'll be boringly conventional and start with the puzzle that's, over here. I'll leave those plinths for later. They'll make good reading material. But, I don't think I necessarily need to read them right now. We might as well just deal with things as they come. Now, there is one extra thing we can do with the ladder that, you couldn't really do in other similar puzzles like this, which is that we can stab this against this post and climb up here. Which means we can get this on dry land. What does this do for us? As stated earlier, these kinds of moves don't do anything when the post that you are trying to rotate your fork against is part of the exact same landmass that you yourself are standing upon. You can, however, push it around. Would stabbing this again facing north have any benefit? Well, for one, it means I can't get past here. So that's an issue. But was I finished with everything I could do with this facing south? Yes, if I want to come through there facing north, Well, A, I'll have to stab the other half of it, which could be doable. Why doesn't this do anything? Well, good question. Is it that the push off the ledge would compute first, and then, like, Steven sees that there's no... There would be, like, a pit underneath it, essentially? And then he doesn't want to make that move? But he's still not doing the ladder move because, to him, the ladder's obstructed. So he's trying to do, like, a normal move, not a ladder move. Or is it just that he doesn't like to get on top of things while they're moving out from the square that he wants to move onto? I could see either of them being reasonable. In any case, I believe the solution is actually... No, that's not it. That's not how you unstab. How do I stab this facing south, but the other way? That's a good question. Because I want to basically bring that with me and unstab it on this very island itself. Right, I did this, I carried it, I put it up here. But now I can't go back because of the other problem. So whatever problem solving I have to do, it's gonna be down here. I don't see how I would do that this way, but I can at least do that this way, which I think amounts to basically the same thing. So that's fine. And I can make a different kind of bridge. In fact, I can push this around. And in fact, I think what I could do is I could even, like, do this. So now it's propped up on the other end. So I was trying to see if there was some way of... Whoops. That won't work, but I can push it south and then down. Now he says, I can do this. And sure, I've half fried a sausage, but I'm sure I can probably deal with that somehow. Like, in fact, I could probably even keep going, right? No, because that would trap me over there. But what I can do instead is use the pole to kind of, do this thing. Which would work if it were supported. Just for the sake of argument, let's, well, okay, maybe let's not do that, then. We kinda don't wanna... We wanna fry, like, the left half, but not the right half, but I don't really see how that's gonna be possible, but... Oh, well. Now that's a problem now, isn't it? I mean, I suppose we can do things like this. If I can turn myself around properly. Yeah, this is another... Oh, well, I'll just go over here. That's fine. Put this back. In fact, even put it back over here. Can do that, but that's a problem. But now I don't have a place to actually do that on. But if I have both of the sausages on the east, then I can maybe do that. So, for example, if I were to fully cook this one, do that, then move that over, that's gonna move that up, which is not what I want. Why isn't this turning over? Is it because... Yeah, why isn't it turning over? It's free to roll over here. It's free to roll when I do that. But when I move it like this, I don't think it's rotating. It's not rotating. Is it because, like, I'm pushing it so it has to move in a certain way, but the land underneath it is just, like, shifting. So... Oh, it's because it's being held up by like both the terrain and the land that, like, is loose. So it's being supported by both a thing that's moving and a thing that's not moving. So it's basically like it's acting like it's being carried by the moving terrain, which it is. In fact, arguably, it's being carried... Well, okay. Well, I guess, like, the fact that it's being moved by a moving terrain more than it is being moved by Steven, like, that's taking precedence. Like, the fact that it's being moved by both of those, like, quote-unquote, at the same time. So, it's, like, being moved in such a way that normally, like, being moved by terrain underneath you that's moving is not a thing that rolls the sausage. And the not rolling the sausage motion takes precedence over the rolling the sausage motion. Even though that was initiated by me myself, the end result is the fact that this sausage here has a rolling and non-rolling component that are, like, working together on it, and it decides to not roll. Which is intriguing, but not really helpful at the current given moment. Okay. Well, I think this thing might have something to teach us, even if it's not something we wish to learn. Which is an unfortunate theme of this game. We could come at this from the other end. Like, if we do that, that's an incredibly interesting new way of losing my fork and drowning. So if I already cooked the right half of the sausage, well, hold up. So at some point or another, a fully cooked sausage is going to have to prop this thing up. Because I do still have to get back here. That's clearly the name of the game. So it is another substitution puzzle, as, like, loosely as you want to phrase that. So the problem is there's, like, a limited number of ways to do that. Well, okay. Not if I prevent this thing from moving by standing on it, though. So, for instance, if I go around it and do this, yeah, there we go. So now we have a fully cooked sausage that's holding this thing up. Now, did I fully cook the right half of this thing? No, I didn't. So now when I do this, it's not done yet. But that's okay, because I can push it back over the grill. Is that enough? Will I be able to finish the puzzle this way? I think I will. I don't see any reason why not. Okay. Well, seems reasonable enough to me. I had to start this thing with a sausage in order to hold up the tree. So, I'm willing to go with it. We'll reload if we have to, but I don't see any reason why not. You know, we took one sausage and we made two out of it. I'd say that's reasonable enough progress to me. Alright. What do you have to say to everyone, sir? Not just me. Look, game, you've already brought up cannibalism. I don't think you have to use euphemisms for it anymore. I mean, you can if you want to, but, you know, it's okay. You can be frank about this kind of thing. I mean, wow. I wasn't even thinking about that one, but gosh. Alright, yeah, we probably want to keep that around. Probably from this end. And then, what of the other one? Well, let's at least just see what the deal is with this one. I don't even know what it looks like yet, so for all I know, like, half this thing is gonna go away. The backbone is, in fact, connected to the skull. In fact, there is no such thing as a backbone. So we can push this thing off. I would like to take this with me, if possible. Over this somehow. Okay, so that'll just fall. And, interestingly, does the bridge go underneath this? No, it doesn't. Both of these squares are, both of these squares are empty, of course. So I have to start over on the left. That panel drops away. I have to get over to the right, because At the very least, there is a... Well, all three of the sausages have to wind up back here. I, myself, do not necessarily have to wind up back there. But it would be nice. One way or another, we're gonna have to probably log roll back on a cooked sausage somehow. But, like, I'm trying to run, like, there's a problem here. The problem is, like, if I put a raw sausage in here and log roll on it, how do I get it back out? I don't know. Do not know. Seems pretty bad if I wind up down here. Because if I'm down here on the bridge, I don't know how I'm getting back out. Unless I have a ladder here. But I don't know how to... I do not know how to move this thing. Okay, well, I can hang it off the cliff. That's interesting. In fact, if I want to do that, I suppose I better push the sausage out the other way so that this remains accessible. I can't lift that, though. Right? Not unless I have another sausage with me. But then I'd be lifting the very thing I'm trying to climb up, which I've never tried to do before, but I might as well at least try it, see what happens. You know, maybe Steven will make a new exciting noise, or maybe it'll just be a normal bump. Who knows? Maybe he will spew a piano solo out from his lovingly absent polygonal non-mouth. Look, I don't know, but we have to try it, right? And it is a use that this sausage has come to, this extra sausage, which I was not sure what to do with, but it is a potential use for it now. And of course this pole, although the pole is kind of placed in the wrong spot too now, isn't it? So I could do that, but I didn't need a sausage to help me with that. Does this thing have a ladder on the other side of it? No, it's definitely only on one side. Definitely just the one. Because of the way this hook is shaped, yeah, there's at least one more piece of, sand on the bottom here, and maybe not anymore. We're definitely not getting anywhere unless we either lift that, or, well, again, like, lift it by climbing up the thing that we're lifting. Or, well, yeah, otherwise support it. But, because of the way it's only gonna be able to be supported by sausages... it's just gonna roll out on into the sea, and we're not gonna be able to kind of bring it around the left side or the north side. So I don't think it's going anywhere other than right here and providing us a ladder. Unless we can lift it up over this somehow and bring it with us. I have no idea how you would do that. Like, this whole, like, climbing up a thing that you yourself is lifting seems kind of hokey to me, but I'm willing to give it a shot. Well, I guess this is the first time we've seen where entering a puzzle with a sad sausage might be relevant, so I guess it's worth a try. Let's just see what happens. We do start with it sabbed. But, of course, then it falls to us to decide what we're gonna do as a result of that, and, it's not pretty. Of course, we could rotate one of these. It's, well within our means at this point, as I have amply demonstrated. But, yeah, still I don't know. Like, none of this, unless there's a ladder somehow that, or some way of rotating that, but I think we can pretty conclusively roll out rotating terrain at this point. I think if it were possible, the game would have had us do it by now. So, I think it's probably not. Unless there's some other mechanic that, like, just hasn't shown up yet. Like, things that rotate that aren't us, or sausages. Things that rotate without our influence, I suppose. Or rotating terrain, one or the other. In any case, so that... This ladder is always going to be facing south. I'd say that's fair to assume now. So even if I do place it down here, what good does that do? Well, theoretically, I could hang it off the cliff here, and then that would become a ladder I could climb up and use to get out from the bottom here. And so if I stabbed a sausage that was in the track while facing west, I could bring that up the ladder along with me, and then unstab it out here, and then substitute it out for one that's cooked. I could see that happening. But, that, of course, that still brings to question, how do we lift this thing? How do you do it? I don't know. There's no way to save any other pieces of terrain from falling down other than things that have outcroppings on them. So, none of this is going to work because this whole thing doesn't have any outcrops, right? Yeah, like, that's a wall. There's no even diagonal movement there. So this thing's gonna fall no matter what. I can't save it. This thing's gonna fall no matter what. I can't save it. North end of the island is also gonna fall no matter what. I can't save it. So, right? No, that's not true at all. I could save it, but if I put a sausage right here. What would that do for me? Let's find out. It seems outlandish, but it's worth a shot. I do have two sausages, after all. Well, exactly what I thought would happen happened. And the other... In the meantime, though, all I have is, still don't really have much else to do here, though. The block is almost the most mysterious part of this whole thing, because, like, the sausages are, I can see how they're important. Like, they're pretty darn important. The bridge, this thing over here, I can see how that's important. That's important, for sure. No doubt about it. But that thing up there, I don't see how that helps. And this block, I don't see how it plays into things yet. Like, it might play into things by being a temporary support at some point or another, but I'm not seeing it yet. Single unit blocks only seem to be useful as bridges, not as supports for anything. Although, sometimes they're useful in, like, towers, I guess. But, in any case, I don't see what holding up that, you know, nice piece of architecture back there has done for me, so I think that's probably just a red herring. It looked funny, though. Actually, I guess I might as well consult your wisdom, too. Maybe you've got something to tell me about the history of this island, or just about how, you know, foolishly dumb I am. Thanks, game. Man, it's gonna be, rich just seeing everybody else react to this stuff. If only because, you know, sometimes it just feels nice, knowing that other people are sharing in something that you also witnessed. And that's, a terrible thing to say about, apocalyptic scenarios, but, it is a thing about human nature. We do like commiserating. Right, so I can... If I put a log in there, I can go over and get another log. But I certainly don't think I want to start out the puzzle with a log in there. That seems kind of counterproductive. Like, if I put a log in there, like, just in the hub world, I don't think that's gonna lead anywhere good. But if I do something like this, I could maybe see that working. Just to free up some space, if nothing else. So, you know, there. Now I have the South Sausage. I can probably get that out at some point or another. I have access to this. But this does not solve the mystery of how do I get the backbone into a good place. Also worth noting is that I can't dismount from a log roll. I should have seen this coming. I really should have, but I just didn't. Also, very annoyingly, the bridge is in the center and not on the two edges, so there's not really any... Well, there, I can do this, though. That's of note. So I can do that anytime I want, almost. In fact, I can do something similar at the upper half here. It's just that this post is on this end and not on the other end. I should also note that I do have, like, those, support posts over here, too, although they're not very high. So I wouldn't be able to, like, kind of row my block along the same way I've been able to do it in other puzzles. Only because, there's just nothing for it to stand on. Like, if I have the block at the very lowest level, such that I'm standing on what's basically level with this terrain up here, then, like, I can't reach these to use as support posts because I'm too far away from them. So that's also interesting to note. So I don't think I'm wrong that sausages still have to go down here at some point. It's just that there's something else going on here. And that something else may well be, hey, buddy, you have to put horizontal sausages in here at some point. So if that's the case, then perhaps what I want to do is bring a horizontal sausage, a raw horizontal sausage, over here into the puzzle. Then I could get to this side, cook both of them, then use a horizontal sausage as a dismount point. Well, I couldn't do that now, could I? No. Because if I put the horizontal sausage into the center, which is the only place I can put it, then while I could I couldn't dismount directly from a vertical sausage, log rolling horizontally onto the horizontal sausage. However, if I put all of my materials, every single last one that I had down here, the two vertical sausages and the horizontal sausages and the block, then I could fill up this whole thing. Fill up the entire, rib cage, for lack of a better word, now that I'm looking at this. And, walk down that, and basically it would jam up the whole thing, and log rolling would no longer be possible. It'd just be normal walking. And, then that would be doable. But, So, you know, this might not be... The fact that this is a plus might not just be for aesthetic purposes. This might represent health and the heart. And perhaps more literally, the heart, perhaps. That I am, what I am suddenly seeing here, and that's probably on purpose. This puzzle certainly could have been oriented the other way, but, it's oriented the way that it is very much on purpose, as many things in this game are. How am I doing on time? Pretty good. I can keep going for a little while longer. Just a little while. Okay. So, where does that leave us? Well, I guess we might as well get started with rotating this horizontal. This has been the closest thing that's, like, made a lot of things fit together. So, I guess it's worth investigating further. Using by our... What are by now industry standard techniques? We still have to leave this somewhere. Well, we could leave it on top of this. And then push it out like we normally do. I mean, that's one way, but that will be a way that works. Except that that won't work, so never mind. We will do it the other way that works, which is this way. That looks like that'll be a way that works. We can even do this, but there's not really much call to it. It still has to go back here. Although, interestingly, I could prop this up with another horizontal sausage, come to think of it. I don't know why I would want to do that. Well, I'll think about it for later. I'll try not to forget I said that. I'll try. Doesn't really matter where I leave this, so I'll just leave it over here for now. That's pretty reasonable. So, what are my steps now? My steps are to rescue this block at some point. I don't know what I want to do with it yet, though. But it does have to, it does have to go out onto this track at some point, so I guess I may as well at least get started with that. And I've already kind of messed up a little bit, because I can't really get that back. Okay, Right. So it is important that I be able to, look, you just get out of the way for now. It is important that there is not a ladder on this side, so I can do that. That's important. Then, honestly, I kind of just want to get rid of this now. So, you go away. It's okay if I push that over there, so that's fine. I can make that move. Then I can bring this up. Then I can put this, not necessarily directly on the track yet. I'm not sure if I want that. But I barely have anywhere else to put this thing. It's pretty in the way. Because I would like to be able to back into here, I guess. Which I could do if I do this. But really, I just need to be able to back up over there and then do that, and then... Alright, well, I guess we'll see what happens if we put it in the groin. Not my most favorite spot to put that, but we'll just work with it. Right. But that doesn't go anywhere for solving our puzzle of, right. So that doesn't solve the problem of how to elevate this thing out of there. So, we are not done with the ladder, for sure. We can't just get rid of it. We do need to figure out how to lift it. How do you lift a ladder without, well, without using the ladder that it is on? Let's just escape here, because we're going to need to do a little bit of thinking on the overworld here, too, I feel. So we could, at any time, use the horizontal sausage instead of the vertical sausage. What does that do for us? It means that we can very, very easily remove that as a cotter pin, I guess, is another thing you could say. Wait, that's not right. Wait, that's like a different kind of pin. I think. Anyway, let's go back to the less clever thing. We can use it as a horizontal supporting mechanism that, like, props up on this piece of land instead of any of the others. So that does leave both of the avenues here, open to us. The problem is that, there's no obvious way of, doing that. Yeah, so we can enter in facing south. So that means we could be holding on to one of these, for example. Holding on to the horizontal sausage. Do this, put it on the south end specifically. Enter while stabbed. And then we can't do that. Right, we'll be holding it out over that end. Right. And if we're facing south, there's no way we can climb the ladder that way. So if we enter in stabbed, we have to unstab. So I don't think entering in stabbed actually helps here. Okay, very well. What of entering Well, we could hang this out over the cliff, I guess, maybe. Well, maybe not quite like that, but maybe like this. That might give us a little tiny bit of extra space in this area. So now this time when we do things like, well, gosh, this is, even with one tile, occupied, this is still kind of a headache. We can put it over there for the time being and not get it back. We're not getting it back, though. Not getting that one back, folks. So we can do that. So, if the last sausage over there is vertical, like if the one I put down there is vertical, then I could potentially, be in a situation where the block down there is vertical. I mean, well, let's see, how does that work? I mean, I guess I can shove it off like that. That potentially works too, and then I could even maybe roll that or otherwise get it off. So I could be in a situation where there's a vertical sausage here, there's a block here, and then this thing is to my south, maybe, and I could have it, I could stab into it, right? Well, we're already getting really, really choked up here. Well, basically what I'm seeing is, yeah, the S shape of, like, the pentomino of, support here. So this would be propped up against this pole here. So this would be placed here, the block would be here, and then this sausage would be here. I could stab it, and then try and climb up the ladder while I'm holding up the thing that is itself holding up the thing that I'm climbing up. And then I don't know what would happen. My guess is that either I would ascend into space and we would leave this puzzle world forever, or we would lose my fork, or nothing would happen. I'd just, like, try and bump into the wall or something. One of those three things would happen. Alright. Well, I'll tell you what. There's an extremely easy way to go back. An extremely easy way to go back to having two vertical sausages that doesn't require me to fiddle around with rotating any of them anymore. And thankfully, this one doesn't require very much transportation, so I don't feel too bad about doing that at all. Yeah, so I'm just gonna see if this leads anywhere intriguing, and if it kind of bottoms out at a natural-looking point, I'll probably call it quits after that, but I don't want to at least see what this leads to. You know, we're not done with silly physics shenaniganry in this game yet. I am of that I am pretty darn sure. We have not seen the last of this nonsense. Still, that kind of leads to the problem of, like, we need to get in and, like, we need to start up here and get in up to the ladder, which implies that the sausage is not, like, the sausage is up north instead of south. But then it also needs to return south while we're still on this side of it, which seems like a tall order. Yeah, so I'm less enthusiastic about that now. Let's just get that out of the way for now. I'll come back for it later, but, if we do, meanwhile, this kind of thing, then that makes it so we still can't really get over to this side. But we could maybe do things of that sort. Well, hold up. There is one last thing that I also didn't try yet that, let's see, do I have time for that? Yeah, I've got time for that. Actually, we're doing fine. I thought I was a lot later than I was. There is one other thing I could do. Notice, again, the specificity. Yeah, the specificity. The specificness. I think I tried to say two of those things at the same time. Of the puzzle. This is only a two-tall ladder. What happens if I build a stack of these things? So, for example, if I, like, use the vertical sausage over here, and also that thing had a... Well, basically the S-shape. If I put the S-shape, or the Z-shape, or whatever you want to call it here, such that this thing was being held up, but there was also a sausage to walk off of this pier onto, would that help me? I think it might. I think that's interesting enough to be worth a try. So that's going to involve moving both of these things down here. Well, not really, no. All it really involves is bringing the first one down here and putting it on my head, but not rotating it, and then climbing up the ladder again, and then bringing that over here. So I can do that. That's no problem at all, really. Except if I leave it on the pews like that, it is. Or chairs, seating, whatever. But specifically, it will have to be in this orientation. That's alright, though. Alright, so what does this get me? We'll have to go around the corner like that, but that's alright. So we build that. That certainly would not be possible inside the puzzle, for sure. So we can do that, and get back out. What has that led us to? Not much. This specific thing hasn't led us to much. If we roll off the other way, then we can get on top of the ladder. And we can do other sorts of piloting around. Or we could just shove that off and maroon ourselves forever with our social anxiety and brittle ankles. Except that they're not brittle. We've seen that they're most definitely not brittle. Whatever they are, that's not brittle. In that case, if we shove this off first, then do things. Then, well, then we just run into that problem. There's no way to lift it. So ultimately, what were we trying to do? Ultimately, we were trying to find a way that we could, one way or another, have a sausage stabbed into our fork while facing east. Have a vertical sausage stabbed into our fork while we're facing east and stab the lower half of it, such that we're in the L shape. We come over here, when one way or another, we come to the position where we have that thing done, and we proceed to try and climb up the ladder. Now, I can think of a way to do that, and it doesn't involve, I don't think it necessarily involves this S-shape at all. In fact, we, well, if I keep on doing, it's going to bring me back to the puzzle. So I'm going to tell you what, I'm going to reload again. Sure. Just get all those sausages out of there. Get them back to where they rightfully belong, at least for now. Their rightful origin point, I suppose. So here is another theory. If I could log roll and lose my fork, what I could do is embed it in a sausage. And if I could lose my fork, I could embed it in the sausage and bring it up in here, and just use the sausage to prop this thing up. Then I can do all my work without having to worry about, like, this thing falling down. And I could basically bring that sausage over here and just start the puzzle with it already in the correct setup, except that that isn't even technically true, because if I did that, what would happen is the sausage would be blocking my way. I can't walk around the sausage. The problem, if you'll recall, is that the sausage is already in the wrong, like, bad position. That, like, I simultaneously want to be holding on to it, and it's blocking the path from here, the starting point, to here, this point. And even then, it would probably wouldn't let me enter the puzzle, because I wouldn't have my fork. So, never mind. That was just an idle thought. So, whatever I do in the puzzle, I'm probably gonna have to do, inside it. However, what this does mean is that if I do manage to pull it off, if I manage to do that, then it's okay to put a sausage in here. So, keeping in mind that I can reload whenever I want, I think I'm just gonna dump that in there. Just gonna dump it. We may find out a way of losing my fork in puzzle. Yeah, out of puzzle is perhaps the wrong context for it, but in puzzle I could maybe find a way around it. Maybe finagle a way to make it happen. Seems iffy. But not really any iffier than anything else. Right. So ultimately, I want to land on the ground. However, for example, we can... Remember how I was remarking about how these things aren't very tall? We could, for instance, start with a sausage on top of them. I could extend this point by growing my own sausage tree. Yeah, or giving this guy fingers, or whatever you want to call it. We're going to put a sausage on top of a post and then use that as a potential propping point for losing my fork. And, where is this going again? Where are my flights of fancy taking me? Like, even if I do that, what's the point? That'll wind up with my fork on top of a sausage at, like, elevated level. I'll have to move that sausage somehow. Which, to its credit, once I do that, the fork will then move somewhere else and presumably be retrievable. So if I do that, the fork will be loose. But if I do that, why would I want to do that? Because what? I still, like, fundamentally speaking, need a way to start with something like this. Either, like, a sausage in this position, or a sausage in the other one. Like, even horizontal, maybe, would work. Sausage horizontal, holding this thing up. And then, from there, figure out a way to basically bring in one of these sausages, that's vertical, south, down into this position. Basically all from, like, topologically this space and anywhere I can walk off onto a sausage onto. Yeah, that's seeming harder. Maybe not impossible, but absolutely, definitely, without a doubt, harder. But everything's so close together, it might still be doable anyway. Yeah, I don't know. I think that's actually probably just enough for tonight. I'm really gonna have to come to grips with this one.